So with anything that we see spiritually, in a murder case obviously can be very graphic. Unfortunately, we get to feel it as well, and we ask the person who's passed away to relive the event, so it's traumatic for that person who's passed on as well, for their soul to go backwards.
How do I cope with it? I don't cope with it. I cry. I meditate, I cry, I deep breathe a lot. I spend a lot of time on my own. I've got a very isolated life. It's the only time I really come out is when I'm helping families or working with spirit.
You're alone, really. You've got no one to talk to or no one to say that, oh, it was just so unbelievable what happened to this person. So it's very, I tell you, this job is very, very lonely.
For me as a person, I tend to go out to the ocean. Basically, when I get home, I have to debrief it. I think the biggest part of it is that I didn't do it, and I can't own it. But if we can make the world a little bit happier or bring some peace, then that makes me happy, and therefore the visualizations just disappear.
It's awful. It's you know, horrible what people have gone through and what families are left with. So I'm better when the souls are okay. If the soul's not okay, then I'm not okay.
When I get home, I never talk, because it's confidential, I never talk about the cases. I don't want to talk about them. And, you know, my husband say, you know, are you okay? And I go, yeah, he knows that I just need time from, I don't speak to anyone. It takes me some days. So I just kind of, in a way, but isolate myself to get myself back on track again, you know, and deal with it that way.
I mean, I've had so much death in my life that I've learned ways to cope with it, and that's what I like to teach people, how to cope with it.
It does take you in a dark place sometimes, and you just have to find yourself again.
But I've learned many little ways that help in a big way, and that's what I'm grateful for.
You don't hold on to it, because it would just do your head in. So the key is just to release, just be grateful for what we've achieved, and then move forward.